Okay. This is a short four-day swordsmanship video for the guys from the US asking me about tramazzone. Where I suspect part of the problem's coming from is how people are actually holding the buckler. The buckler should be held so that the second knuckle point to the face of the buckler. Okay, so that actually squares our buckler up, allowing us to do what we need to do to move the sword around the buckler. What we generally see is the third knuckle's doing this, which is creating this interference for the tramazzone. At least I suspect this is what's happening. With our squared on position, the thumb here is pointing at 2 o'clock. Is that coming through, Dave?
Yep.
Okay. So the thumb there at 2 o'clock, starting from Cotalunga Alta, the tramazzone is made by tracking our forte over the buckler, to come back, coming straight through. Over, coming straight through. I don't actually need to turn my hand to do this. My buckler is stationary, all the movement is coming from the hand. Similarly, it can be made underneath, cutting to the other side of the buckler. We do get into some situations where we can actually keep them turning as a unit, which gives both hand and buckler a little bit extra coverage. This is turning at 10 o'clock with the thumb on the buckler, coming straight back. So essentially I'm resting the edge of the blade on the buckler, turning it over, coming back with the cut. Then actually starts to speed the tramazzone up. Then gets added into footwork. The key is having this almost face forward buckler. Second of that is having the hips square. If the hips aren't square, as we're letting this back foot drop, I'm going to again start having a situation where my buckler pulling behind the sword. This is where, again, it catches up. Squaring up the hips brings the buckler forward to allow the tramazzone. At least that's the way I do it.